The power supply weld sequence is started with the push of a button, striking the arc of the fully automatic, self-completing weld cycle. The thickness of the square butt weld joint in the cavity area is just under a quarter inch. The material is alloy 2219 aluminum, welded in the aged condition, then re-aged after welding. Welding current and voltage, as well as the turntable speed, are programmed continually throughout these corners. An inherent part of the application program is to maintain the surface of the part level below the torch. This provides stability of the weld puddle, resulting in good bead contour, even in the most severe corner of short radius. All welding parameters are normally maintained constant in long, continuous areas, and the computer is reading the digital output of the drive encoder, in this case the turntable shaft position. The next table position flag triggers the computer to read the next data line from its memory. The next line at this joint contains a data word to command the torch rotation motor to operate. The torch arm assembly must be repositioned 180 degrees to permit re-entry into the cavity area from the opposite side. The weld is completed at the point of weld bead overlap. The rate of downslope of current and the RAM stop delay is programmed by the preset controls of the power supply. The assembly is then removed from the fixture, turned around, and remounted for welding the bulkhead on the opposite end, which will contain the missile's folding wings. Again, gets a bulkhead welded to each end. But it has two girth welds at each end joining two D-shaped cylinders of the center section to the bulkheads. A weld certification specimen simulating one end of the midbody is being welded here. The weld pass is started inside the wing slot where it will overlap at completion. A torch arm of smaller profile is used in this restricted area. The torch is water-cooled and has an extra-large ceramic cup and gas lens which provide good gas coverage. It also has an oversized conductor cable for operating beyond its normal current rating. 300 amperes are delivered in some areas. A key to obtaining consistent weld penetration and bead contours is the use of a special pre-placed weld backup tape under the weld joint of production assemblies. The self-adhering tape is hand-laid in during fit-up and is simply pulled out after the welding. Prior to welding, the parts have had all dimensions held in the weld joint area to about 10% of nominal. After welding, the assembly is X-rayed. Defects, if any, found in the welds are very rarely attributed to the computer-controlled welding operation. This completed mid-body structure with its four computer-controlled welds shows that continuous single-pass welds can be made on production assemblies in unusually confined areas. This application of computer control provides product improvement and cost reductions, which could be expanded to other manufacturing operations.